Projects and Tasks in Nosby. Hi, in this video, you'll learn everything about projects in Nosby. Here you can see my project list. Free Nosby accounts are limited to 5 projects. Paying customers can create an unlimited number of projects. Let's create a new one. Let's assume that my website needs a fresh look. It needs some major changes. In the project view in Nosby, you can see your project list and task list. That's it. This way you can focus on getting things done. You will find all the project settings and options in the info bar. We will talk more about that a bit later. For now, let's create a few tasks. John is a friend of mine who redesigned his blog a few weeks ago. I think his experience will help me out. Task parameters. When you open a task, its details will appear. All its parameters are available here. Let's move the Meet with John task to my private project to show you how easy it is. There will be quite a lot to do here. I'd better invite my assistant to this project so that she can help me. Collaboration is key. By the way, take a look at the project icons. This one stands for a shared project, and this one means that the project is private. Thanks to images, it's easy to distinguish them on a long projects list. Let's get back to our project. We need a new skin, and Sarah has a better sense of design. I'd better delegate this task to her so that the project can move forward right away. Let's set a deadline for this task to be sure it's ready by Friday. The task parameters improve your performance by providing you and your colleagues with specific information on what should be done and when. The new site will have a section for first-time visitors. I want it to be really well-crafted, so I'm planning to work on it for a few hours. Testimonials play an important role. I'll be asking clients for some positive feedback today. Hopefully they reply promptly. And as I work with new fantastic clients, it would be great to learn what they think on a regular basis. Not too often, though. I don't want to bother anyone. Why not to set the recurrence for this task then and be reminded to contact new clients every 3 months? This way, if I mark this task as done today, it will jump back on the priority list in 3 months. This feature is great when you want to do something periodically. The last parameter a task can have is category. You will learn about that in an upcoming video in this series. Comments and extra features. Sometimes you need to precisely describe the task you delegate to get the result you expect. You can do that in a comment. Let's explain the idea of the new site to Sarah. Apart from text comments, you can also use short checklists, links, YouTube videos, images, and any other files to comment on tasks in Nosby. We will talk more about comments and collaboration in one of the next episodes in this series. Now let's take care of the video to be placed on the homepage. That's quite a challenging task. While creating this project, we put down all the things and actions needed to create a new site, but we didn't really pay attention to the scope of the tasks listed. In this case, we need to write a script, have it proofread, find someone who can record it, and then edit it and so on. As you can see, this task is, in fact, a project. No worries, in Nosby you can convert a task into a project with a few simple steps. We will plan the video production project in more detail later on. Right now, it's time for photos and graphics. Sarah will definitely find something great online, but I also have some cool photos in my library. In order to avoid confusion, let's clone this task and delegate each copy to a different person. It's a super handy feature when you want to copy a task to your private project or delegate several similar tasks to your colleagues. When you clone a task that was not delegated to you, the new clone task will be. Let's set some more parameters for other tasks in this project and complete one. Look at the bottom of the main view. You can see the project statistics there. This works for every other project, inbox, and priority list, too. It contains the number of tasks, active and completed today, as well as the time needed to complete all of them, providing you use the time needed parameter. Please note that all completed tasks will stay at the bottom of the list till the end of the day. This way, you can see how much you've done today. Afterwards, they'll be moved to the completed tasks section. Pro tip. Now it's time for our pro tip. When you click on the 3 dots icon at the bottom of the main view, you'll activate edit mode. This way, you can complete, change parameters, or move several tasks to a different project all at once. This also works from the project list view. Project info bar. Let's go back to our private project and open its info bar. This is how it looks if you don't share the project with anybody. Now let's move back to the shared project again so you can see the difference. As we've set a few task parameters, we can now filter tasks in this project. There are lots of filters available here, but you can only see those that apply to this project. We only want to see my tasks for now. There are lots of ways you can sort tasks, for instance, by due dates. All filters and sorting options can be turned off with just one click. With the print feature, you can create a PDF file with projects, tasks, and comments. When you click on the avatar of another project participant, you'll see all collaborators. If you are a project admin, you can invite more people to the project right here. You can also change the project color. This change will be visible in many places in the interface. First, the whole project will be colored. Second, when you switch to the priority list, a big dot on the left side of the project name will be filled with your chosen color. It's a great way to quickly visualize what's on your priority list when you open Noseby in the morning. Our users love using colors for projects. It's cool to customize your Noseby system. The next two buttons in the project's info bar are labels and templates. We'll talk about them later on. At the very bottom, you can complete the whole project or delete it. Pro tip. Just one more thing. You can add an attachment to a project. It can be any kind of file, a link, or a simple note. In this view, you can also find all attachments added by anyone to any task in this project. These will always be listed below project attachments. That's all for now. Next, you'll learn everything you need to know about the priority list in Noseby.